The Australian economy is expected to take its biggest hit in history when Wednesday's national accounts confirm the nation is officially in a deep recession. It comes as Federal Treasury tips more Victorians will be on JobKeeper by Christmas than the rest of the country combined.
Sunday should be a day of rest and goodwill. Hey, Joshy. But there was little charity on offer from the Treasurer for the Victorian Labor leader.
In Victoria, we've seen a litany of failures.
Josh Frydenberg hit out at the government led by Daniel Andrews, blaming its incompetence for unleashing Victoria's second wave.
Well, the costs are immense. Treasury have said $10 to $12 billion is the hit to the Australian economy over the September quarter.
I'm not interested in having an argument with anybody, really, other than with this wildly infectious virus.
The federal government now expects about 1,400,000 Victorians to be on JobKeeper by the end of December, or 60% of the 2.25 million Australians tipped to still be on the wage subsidy by Christmas.
What I would say is this: there is no economic recovery until you get the health problem fixed.
Victoria is a quarter of Australia's economy, and its lockdown is hurting the nation.
These are very tough times for the Australian economy, but the Australian economy is remarkably resilient.
We are about to learn how tough. Australia's economy hit reverse in the 3 months to the end of March, when growth fell by 0.3%. With the June figures out on Wednesday, the government is expecting much worse, tipping GDP to fall by 7%, posting the biggest quarterly contraction in Australia's history, and with two negative quarters back to back, proof of the nation's first recession since 1991. Which is why the opposition argues that increased wage subsidies and unemployment benefits should continue at their current rates.
The idea that you withdraw support in the current circumstances is, in my view, premature and will lead to a deeper and longer recession.
JobSeeker and JobKeeper were timed to end in September. This week, the government will move to extend those deadlines and begin stepping down the amount of the payments. And it's likely to find that withdrawing billions of dollars in support, like fighting the virus, is diabolically difficult. Chris Yuleman, Nine News.